What's going on, everybody? Kevin Blinkoff here, and today I'm talking about a relatively new lure company, local lure company called Island X. Island X lures are Nantucket-based, and what I love about local lure companies like Island X is that they're designed for local fishing. So these are striper, bluefish, albie lures designed to work in the Northeast. Island X first came on the scene with their lure right here. This is the Hellfire 180. And this was designed to be kind of a hybrid lure. So it's kind of somewhere between a typical pencil popper and a needlefish. Designed to be weighted to cast into the wind and reach really far from shore was the original design. But really it's a shore or a boat lure. Because it's weighted to cast far, it does sink. So the way to work this lure, long cast and then usually a fast retrieve, twitching it on the surface, trying to make it dance and splash, and that's where it's been really popular. It imitates two baits, really. That kind of topwater splashy retrieve really looks a lot like a squid trying to escape. I've fished this lure in rips when there's squid around and stripers and blues feeding on them, and it has that action of coming up, looking like an escaping squid, splashing around us side to side. Also, a lot of fishermen are finding that you can let this lure sink and work at subsurface, kind of more like a weighted sinking needlefish. And in that case, it looks kind of like a sand eels. There are some fishermen who really like to fish this even at night. They come in some dark colors as well for that. And you can let it sink, drag it along the bottom of a sandy bottom like a needlefish, or fish it kind of middle of the water column, subtle swimming action, and that can be really productive as well. Along with this 180 size that became really popular, they also make a smaller size that's really popular with albies, long cast, fast retrieve, albie lure. And then they make it in two larger sizes as well, the 200 and the 220. And those are big sizes, really designed for surf casting especially. So good long casting striper lure there. Really popular, and that's what's put Island X really on the map and launched their lure brand. Since then, they've added some other lures to the lineup. So another lure that Island X has come out with since is this called the Stinger Minnow. And this is like a lipless bait, swims subsurface, but it's got a willow blade attached to the back. And so it actually, when it comes in the package, it comes with two blades. One of them is called the Vibe Blade, and that gives you more resistance and allows you to work it at a slower speed. And that's really kind of a popular way to fish this lure for bass and bluefish. And then there's this speed blade. It's a smaller, darker blade, so it's a little less flashy and it allows you to work the bait faster. And that's typically when this bait is fished for albies, bonito, even bluefish as well. And you wanna make a cast and have a fast retrieve for those fish. You'll notice again, single inline hook on this. And that's something that Island X does with all of their lures. So for conservation, for healthy release of striped bass in particular, they use all single inline hooks. A third lure that Island X has just come out with, and this is their newest one, the Sidewinder. And this is the XL version. So they have a regular Sidewinder that's smaller, and then this XL version, which is the newer one. It comes in two versions. There's a 2 ounce slow sinking version, and then there's a 1.75 ounce floating version. And so you can see here again, the idea, two inline hooks for easy catch and release, has a rattle inside, high pitched rattle, and it's also pretty well weighted for casting. So the idea is that this is kind of a spook style lure or a subsurface walk the dog lure that's well weighted for casting. I fished this lure in the floating version, and what I found is it's a little bit tail weighted for casting. So when it sits on the surface, it floats, but the tail starts to sink, which is a neat action because a lot of times you can let it pause and that's when a fish will hit it. Also, when you work it, because of where the line tie is located and the shape of the lure itself, you can do a slow kind of surface walk the dog, get a really nice rhythm to it. If you get a little more erratic with it, a little faster, some bigger twitches, you can kind of make it jump. You can make it even dive a little bit, and you really get kind of not your typical walk the dog back and forth action, but kind of a more wild injured minnow erratic action. The sinking version or the slow sinking version, you can kind of count that down. So launch a cast out, let it hit the surface and wait for it to sink a bit. Then you can work that back like a subsurface lure. It's again, a pretty erratic action. You can kind of do a walk the dog, but you can also really make it dart wildly. You can speed it up and bring that lure to the surface. So even the slow sinker, work it fast enough, it'll come up to the surface and then kind of let it on the pause sink back down. Now I talked to Nick from Island X Lures and he really recommended replacing that back hook with their inline bucktail. So they sell these as well. He said when you add that inline bucktail on the back, it just gives it a really great action that especially on the pause and slowly, when you're fishing it slowly, that bucktail just gives it a little extra. And he said he's seen a lot of times striped bass and other fish following this lure. And when he stops it and pauses it, that bucktail really seems to get them to key in on that and actually commit and strike. And they come three to a package. So these are the bucktail hooks. They're 5/0 for this XL size lure. And that's kind of my favorite that I'm really most excited about fishing this year is this Sidewinder XL and the floating version. Putting these bucktail hooks on the back because this type of walk the dog, spook style lure is just so productive. There's other ones on the market, but this one has kind of a different action to it, a different rattle. So if I'm throwing a spook, fish are reacting to it, but they're not striking. I'll switch it up and throw this one and see if that different action or more erratic action really performs. Comes in a bunch of great colors, all proven striper colors, bunker patterns. This one here is the electric chicken. That's probably my favorite. You can see it's got this cool reflective hologram side on it. So that's the Island X lineup. I strongly suggest checking them out. Support local lure makers. They make lures that are for the fish and the types of fishing you do. If you fish rips, if you fish backwaters, if you fish big water, they've got options for all of those. They're quality made lures, through wires, all of them, so they're made to catch big striped bass. Check them out at the Island X website.